Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss about some important works of William Wordsworth. As in last video we saw that he was born on April 7, 1770 in Cumberland, located in Lake District of England. He graduated from Cambridge University. As you know, he is known as poet of nature. Okay, let's go further. Some important works of William Wordsworth. So you must know that questions may come in chronological order. You have to be asked that arrange these works, arrange his works in a chronological order. So you must be careful about the year. Okay, descriptive sketches 1793, lyrical ballads 1798. As you know, lyrical ballads were published in 3 volumes. The first was in 1798, poems in 2 volumes. 1807, guide to the lakes 1810, the excursion 1814, Laodamia 1815, The White Doe of the Raleigh Stone 1850, Peter Bell 1819, Benjamin the Wagner 1819, The Prelude. Okay, and some important prose works are Prose Work 1996, Literary Criticism 1966, Letters of Dorothy and William Wordsworth 1967, Letters of the Wordsworth Family 1969, Prose Works 1974, The Love Letters of William and Mary Wordsworth, Essay Upon Epitaph. Okay, so these are the important works. You must learn their names and their year also. A list of important poems in lyrical ballads. Okay, as you know, there were 3 volumes. So in first volume, Simon Lee. Okay, then we are 7. Lines written in early spring, expostulation and reply, the tables turned, the thorn, lines composed a few miles above Tintern Abbey. This is very important poem. Okay, so you must remember and read something about the poem in lyrical ballads, that was published in 18, preface to the lyrical ballads. So you must remember that in first volume there was no preface, but in second volume preface was put. Okay, preface to the lyrical ballads, strange fits of passion have I known, she dwelt among the untrodden ways, 3 years she grew, a slumber did my spirit seal. Okay, I traveled among unknown men, important, Lucy Gray, important, the 2 April mornings, the solitary reaper, nutting, the ruined cottage, Michael, the kitten at play. Okay, in poems, that was in 187, resolution and independence, I wandered lonely as a cloud, that is daffodils. Okay, you must be familiar with the poem, my heart leaps up, odd intimation of immortality, intimation of immortality. Okay, very important. Ode to Duty, important, the solitary reaper, elegiac stanzas composed upon Westminster Bridge, September 3, 1802, London 1802, the word is too much with us, it is also important. Okay, the preface to the lyrical ballads. Here we are going to discuss some points, some matter that was explained in the preface to the lyrical ballads. Okay, as you know, regarded as the manifesto of the Romantic movement. You must know that Coleridge and Wordsworth are known as the father of the Romantic age. Wordsworth and Coleridge reject the new classical trends and declare the dawn of Romantic imagination and freedom. Okay, means before them it was new classical age, means classical, after that new classical. In those days writers used to write in following a strict way of rules and regulations, okay, rhyming scheme, difficult words, okay, they were strict to city lives, okay, gentry, okay. But Wordsworth and Coleridge rejected all these things. They started writing about common people, writing about day-to-day life. They used common words, okay, and this trend started by them. Incidents and situations from common life has been chosen by him to be depicted in his poetry. Okay, means Wordsworth started writing about incident and situation from common life, people of village areas, people of poor environment, people of unhygienic condition. Okay, so he started writing all these things. Whereas before him, writers used to write about gentry, rich people, city life, typical, you can say, rules and regulation, typical dressings, all these things. The use of language is inspired by the language really used by men, simple and colloquial. Yes, as I told you, he started using simple words, simple language. Colloquial language means used by people in general communication, bolchal ki bhasha. So Wordsworth started using these words. Okay, good poetry should produce excitement in coexistence with an overbalance of pleasure. Okay, means according to him, poetry should excite the people. Okay, people must have interest in the matter about which poetry is explaining. Okay, but it should be balanced. Okay, not in negative direction. Okay, a poet is a man speaking to men, more lively sensibility, more enthusiasm and tenderness, who has a greater knowledge of human nature and a more comprehensive soul than one supposed to be common among mankind. Yes, man is speaking to man means whatever poet is thinking, whatever poet wants to convey to the people, to the readers, that message should be conveyed to them, whatever he feels, spirituality, okay, manliness, okay, and goodness, all the messages, theek hai, tenderness, enthusiasm, okay, all the things, his thoughts should be conveyed to the readers. Means a poet should write the poetry in such a way. Okay, after that the prelude, his very famous composition, and actually it is a biographical poem. Subtitle of the prelude is Growth of a Poet's Mind, an autobiographical poem. Theek hai, so you must be asked that what is the other name of, or what is the subtitle of the prelude. So Growth of a Poet's Mind, an autobiographical poem. So the prelude was published in 3 volumes. First version, it came in 1799. Wordsworth started writing in 1798 and it came out in 99. So in first version there were 2 books only, and in second version, that came in 1805, it means after 6 years, in second version there were 13 books, first 2 and 11 new. So total it became 13 in numbers. Okay, final version, it came in 1850 after the death of Wordsworth. Okay, one more book was included, that was conclusion. Okay, so total in the prelude there are 14 books. So in book 1 and 2 recounts his childhood experience, his school experience and his fascination for nature. Okay, how he studies in schools, what was his experience, about his experiences in school, about his friends, childhood, all these things. Okay, so he mentioned these things in book 1 and 2. In book 3, time at the Cambridge University, distancing from nature, falling deep into self-absorption. Yes, while reading, while studying in Cambridge University, he was away from nature, he was busy in his studies. Okay, among his friends, he learned about the words, the all the things. Means he was not able to, he did not have time to look into nature. In book 4, he explained about his summer vacation. In 5th book, a list and description of all his books, his favorite. Okay, so books, topics, materials, what he read is mentioned in book 5. In book 6, walking expeditions in the Alps, his encounter with the life of things, insights of the spiritual, intermingling of the self and the nature. In book 7, life in London, disillusionment with mankind. Means in 6 and 7, he has talked about his attachment to nature, how he came in contact with nature, how he realized the importance of nature. He thought that nature is the best healer, nature has the solution of all the problems of men. Okay, and how he came to believe in spirituality, all the things are explained in books 6 and 7. In book 8, restoration of faith in humanity and virtue of love for nature. After his previous experiences, how he developed faith in humanity and virtue of love for nature, and how he came to know importance of the nature. As you know, he has said that nature is a living soul. So all these things he explained in book 8. Book 9, 10 and 11, his experience and interaction with France, both before and after the revolution, the negative impact that white bloodshed had on him. He shared his experience that he had from the revolution of France. Okay. And in book 12 and 13, epiphany, while climbing the Mount Snowdon, that the self and the nature exist in a harmonious balance, faith in the power of imagination. Means he imagined that nature and human, they are supplementary to each other, they live together, they must live together in a harmonious way. Means nowadays we are talking about sustainable development. Somewhere in these two books he is talking about in that direction. Okay, and book 14 was conclusion. So that's all about the prelude. Okay, in next video we'll discuss about some questions related to William Wordsworth. That's all for today. Thank you.